Good morning, investors and traders. In today's segment, we'll be talking about Dow Jones and especially what is going on with Dow Jones. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, I highly recommend you to do so. Before we do anything, it is important for me to go through this brief disclaimer and risk warnings, which is right in front of you. Now, let me bring out the MT4 platform, which is right in front of you, and the day time frame is your daily time frame. Very briefly about myself, I come with a wealth of 15 years of trading experience. During this time period, I have worked as a hedge fund trader for Bank of New York Mellon and as an equity trader with Bank of America, currently providing services as a chief analyst to Evertrade. Now, previously in our analysis, we talked about the prices being oversold over here, like one price when the RSI came over here, and more recently when the RSI came over here, we talked about the opportunity of the prices forming is some sort of a bottom, but now the price has very much so failed to break above the 200-day simple moving average. As you can see previously, yes, we did see the double bottom, not exact double bottom, your theoretical, like your textbook double bottom, but a double bottom was formed. But now the fact that the price is failing to break above the 200-day simple moving average, which is over here in green, this is your 100 and followed by that is your 200, represent to us that look, the price has actually more room to go to the downside. And the question really is, how low are we going to see the Dow go? So in order to find that, what we really have to see is we have to see where is the next important support zone. So for us, the next important support zone when it comes to the Dow Jones Industrial Average on the same time frame, on the daily time frame, is really the consolidation area over here. Now yes, we can reduce the area slightly a bit, we can just bring it a little bit down like that. So it's going to be running between 33,081. That is your area number one. But if the price fails to break above that, or to stay above that support zone, then we are going to be focused on the next important support zone, which is going to be running between 30,379 to 30,654. In between that, we do have another support zone at 31,953, which may help the price. But if the price breaks over here, the 32,000 sort of a price level, then really the important area is that 30,379 to 30,654. But at the time, it would mean that the RSI would be very much dropped quite low. What is the lowest low in terms of the RSI that we can be looking at? We could be looking at that this particular low, which was formed back in last year in February time, and it's the reading is 13. So it can actually continue to move lower and lower than this one. But one important thing that what we do need to make sure that we don't lose our attention to is that the RSI, if you look at it from the previous one, so RSI has a low, RSI has a higher low, now the RSI has a higher low. If we look at the price and the price itself, what we really see in terms of that is that we don't really see that very clearly, because what we see is a low, we see a lower low, and now the price is forming a slightly higher low. So let's see how that, because if that divergence exists, meaning that the RSI continues to show that we are having a less momentum to the downside while the price makes lower lows, then that means that these lower lows are not going to last, and then the price is going to eventually move to the upside. And if it does, then the first point of action for the price, the first resistance, is going to be your 200, followed by that it is going to be your 100 and your 50-day simple moving average in around that 34,000, and then we will see the price moving towards its all-time high. Stay up to date, and then make sure you subscribe to our channel. We'll be back with more updates.